notice how when squirrels leap from branch to branch or tree to tree that they never seem to fall? Well, researchers with Armory funding have noticed the same thing, and they're trying to see how they might be able to apply some of the biomechanics of how a squirrel moves to future robots. A lot of this research is being done out of the University of Berkeley, California, and also the University of Nebraska. Now, through Armory funding, they basically discovered ways in which they can measure certain types of nerve reactions and impulses, ways that squirrels jump from place to place and adjust mid-air sometimes, doing a kind of what they call a squirrel parkour, jumping off of walls from beam to beam. They've been measuring this with wild squirrels on college campuses such as Berkeley and getting results that are pretty interesting. And they're going to try to take this information and see what data they can extrapolate from it to bring to robotics and robotics work. Essentially, what it would do would give robots a chance to move around real terrain in ways that humans can't.
The capabilities that we see in nature that we want to emulate and replicate shifts away from this paradigm where we tell a robot, perform X by doing Y, and instead say, you are capable of Z, perform X. So in that later model, the robot is aware of all of its capabilities, and it, in a way, allows the robot to do some creative decision-making, for lack of a better term, about which of its capabilities it's going to employ to accomplish a specific task. The squirrel gets to decide in this model what limb it jumps from to reach a certain objective, how it's going to jump based on the stiffness of that limb. And by studying those behaviors and inferring the controller behaviors and actuator behaviors going on in the squirrel's brain and in its limbs, and its spine and its trunk, we can derive principles to develop robots that are capable of similar versatility.
So right now we have a lot of robots in factory settings doing assembly line work, or even in laboratories such as Boston Dynamics, where they're seeing robots jump onto boxes or move in a very linear way. That's not the way they're going to have to move out in the real world, especially in a future battle space where there'll be lots of obstacles, lots of threats. So basically, scientists are looking to the animal kingdom to figure out ways in which they can move beyond thinking human and thinking all kinds of capabilities. If you want a robot to fly, you got to look at birds, you can't look at people. If you want a robot to leap like a squirrel, you got to look at squirrels. Now, this is very early stage research. They've really just started doing this in a laboratory setting. Well, the lab actually being the campuses of, say, Berkeley, where they're doing it out in the field with almost an obstacle course setup for the squirrels to run through and get treats. But in the future, it could be part of a capability of a robot battle buddy of a future soldier. So say that soldier's walking through an urban terrain, they need to see what's up on the top of a building. Well, they send the robot up there. The robot parkours its way up there the way a squirrel would, finds out what's going on, relays it back to the soldier, keeps the human safe. So that's kind of the goal, the end goal. Could be decades away, but the initial research is here and very promising. Reporting for Defense News Weekly, I'm Todd South.